So you have decided to give the Godot engine a try? That is a great choice. It is a very capable engine for 2D and 3D as well. In this video, we will give you a starting point on how the engine works and hook you up with more resources. Godot can be installed for free from the official website or Steam. It is a really small download and you will not need an account or an additional IDE. You don't even need to install it. When we start a game engine, it asks us if we want to head to the demo project library. There are a lot of useful demos for all kinds of things. Let us take a look at one of them. When we download and install Dodge the Creeps, we can play this nice little game. Just click on the play button on the top right. The most interesting features are WASD movement, spawning of enemies, collision detection, and sound.
In Godot, scenes and nodes play a huge role. A node is something you would call a game object or game entity in other engines. A scene is just what we call a collection of nodes. Here on the left, you can see that the nodes are organized in a hierarchy. On the top level, there is the main node. It is of the simplest node type, node. It just acts as a container for the other nodes within it. In Godot, there are quite a lot of predefined node types. This one, for example, is called color rect. It is used for a colored rectangle. You can click it and inspect its properties. Let's change the color. Other examples of such simple node types are timers or the music player.
Some of the more complex functionality cannot be implemented with predefined nodes alone, such as the player. The player looks like a single node at first, but when we look closer, we can see that there is a whole scene behind it. We can inspect the scene in a separate window by pressing the clapperboard icon. The player itself is composed in a similar way to the main scene, with a main node, but this time the main node is of a more complex type. It is an area. Areas allow for collision checking and need to have a collision shape below them. And we can see, here it is. Also, the player has an animated sprite and a particle system that makes a trail. The player comes to life by the use of a script. In this case, it is attached to the main node of the player scene. We can click it and the GDScript editor opens.
GDScript is a scripting language and quite similar to Python. Let us look at a few important things within this script. We see two predefined callback functions, underscore ready and underscore process. Ready is called by the engine once the node is done instantiating. So this is where you put initialization code. Process is called every frame, and delta is the time passed since the last frame. It is frame rate dependent how often this function is called. In cases where this is not wanted, you can use physics process, that is always called within the same time difference. In this example, the process defines the player movement. The player's velocity is based on keyboard inputs. This call is quite self-explanatory, but let us pretend we do not know what it does. We can simply click Search Help and search for Is Action Pressed to find the documentation. It does what we expect it to do.
The actual movement happens by changing the position of the player node. It has a position property because the player inherits from Area 2D. We see that on the top. Area 2D can be clicked and we can see that it inherits from collision object 2D, which inherits from node 2D, which is where the position property comes from. You can also press Ctrl left click on the position to see where it is inherited from. The script is parameterized by the movement speed export var. An export var is a variable that you can change in the properties, so multiple instances of a scene can have different values. We can change the speed just for fun. In Godot, nodes and scenes can be layered as deep as you want. This will be your best friend when implementing complex functionality.
So we hope you got a basic idea of how a project is structured in Godot. There is still much to learn. We would recommend you to play around with the different node types. We link you a lot of useful resources in the description. Some topics that are worth learning next are collision detection, particle systems, and how to instance a scene. We have a series where we show some useful tricks and unknown features of Godot, and we make tutorials for visual effects and shaders. Also, we make devlogs about our action roguelite Persifer's Fungeon, which of course we develop in Godot. In case you need help or just want to talk to us, message us on Twitter or join our Discord. Have a nice day!